Exciting, right? So we are all part of this exciting gaming industry. Gaming industry is a pretty thrilling place to be, as we are connected, creative and passionate people who work here. We lead the world in an interactive entertainment. We inspire the world to play. So as an HR professional, what am I doing here? Well, I started my career with EA 13 years back when EA established its first office in Hyderabad, that is in India. And I've been associated with this company. I was not a gamer when I joined the company, but now I do spend time playing games. I have two kids who are really gamers for their age. As an HR professional, how do I contribute to the gaming world? I help the company to build a real inclusive culture, to enable the talent who join our company to be innovative and to be able to do impactful work. We provide them with career development and learning opportunities, and also help them to get successful in terms of their aspirations and all the value addition that they add to our games. Now let me take you down to the memory lane, where we have all these games which were quite pixelated. If you look at these images, you can see that there has been a long way that the games have evolved over a period of time. I think some of you would have played them earlier. I think, sorry guys, I think this is just like, yeah. Now coming to our platforms, 10 years ago, we had three primary platforms, that is PC, Xbox, and PS2. And in year 2000, we had close to 200 million players worldwide. Now, this is the data from 2017, where we have close to 2.4 billion players, and we have different platforms where we are able to play different games. Now, when we look at Earth's population, we are close to 7 billion. It means that approximately there are 30% of the world population who are playing video games. So when you look at this kind of a data, you can understand by 2022 the kind of options that we have, the kind of gamers that we would be having. Gaming is also about multi-user and online experience right now. What is the current state of the industry? Explosion of mobile and tablet games, gamers using social features. Platforms, OEMs, realize gaming is critical and source of entertainment and engagement and monetization. Disruptive models, that is free to play or freemium games. Games as service, worldwide revenue from sale is increasing on year-on-year basis. How does it impact us? More consumers now play games than ever before. Gaming is more ubiquitous than ever before. Greater choice, easy accessibility, multiple platforms, free to play. For developers, markets and consumers are now more accessible. However, we need to change and adapt design approach to new paradigms. Quality, innovation, multiple platform presence, robustness of backend infrastructure continue to be the fundamental pillars. Now, the story is no different when we come to India. Indians seem to be playing everything that is available on the market. Esports and competitive gaming seems to be up these days. When we look at these games, like when we look at Ludo King, highest downloaded game in 2017, Clash Royale reportedly having an audience base of 5 million players on a daily basis. Poker and card-based games engage audience across India. Match-3 games like Bejeweled and Candy Crush are household names in India. I really do not have to mention about PUBG. To be honest, I think it is one of the most popular games right now. My two kids are also very much engaged with this game. So I have no introductions about this game. Now, when we talk about all these things, we talk about the India opportunity. That is how, as resources or talent in the gaming industry, how can you be part of the future of entertainment? Now, let's look at some of the data points. Like, there are three key factors for any product or business to be successful in any region. When we're talking about market, India is home to 1/10 world's gaming market. There are 387 million smartphone users a couple of years ago to potentially 585 million by 2020. Accelerated economic growth leading to meaningful growth in gaming, where average revenue per user on Android is grown 2x in the last 2 years, and which means there's a largest potential to grow further. In 2017, reported number of mobile gamers, that is 222 million, driving 89% of gaming spends. 1/3 of this audience plays 5 days a week, and 40% of them spend more time than 6 hours a week. Companies who are looking to invest and grow, for example, EA has been in Hyderabad and India for more than 13 years. We have other companies which has presence like Zynga, Glu, Tencent, etc. Talent pool. When we're talking about talent, from a talent perspective, largest and some of the best engineering talents comes from India. Product analytics, product management talent pool succeeding world over comes from India. Some of the largest talent pools for creating art for movies are games in India. Colleges and schools are now offering courses in game design and game art. I can just go back to the time when we just started up with EA and we were hiring. It was really very difficult even to find game testers at that time. We had to really look for resources who had the passion for playing games. And today in our company, we have some successful people who started their role as testers in our organization, and they're doing extremely well, who are part of our mid-management and top management. Some of them were even able to find opportunities outside India, and they're doing very well in our studios in other locations. Now, when we talk about typical roles at EA, these are the list of roles which any of the typical companies would have, right from in QA. You start with QA testers, lead, project managers, managers, engineers, artists and designers, online community managers, product analysts, product management, dev directors, producers, human resources, and finance. So when we're talking about it, as the industry is evolving, there's a huge potential for all of us to leverage the opportunity and build our skills and capabilities. Currently, this is what we are surrounded with based on all the information that I have shared during my presentation. There's an increase in number of gaming platforms made available to larger consumer needs. Gaming is all about multi-user and online experience, faster connection, better purchasing power mechanisms, personalized recommendation, frictionless shopping, easy playing experience, etc. are all contributing to this. Women are increasing playing games on mobile devices like iPads and iPhones, suggesting that these devices have been successful at broadening the target demographic for interactive entertainment. Based on all these things, it is definitely like all of you, when you are thinking about your career and all, there is a lot of scope to bring in your talent and passion. And as a HR professional, what I can say working in EA is, if you're really creative and passionate, then gaming industry is one of the best industries that one can start their career, or they can be part of that gaming industry. Today, in front of all of you, I really stand here and say with pride that it has been one of the best industries to work with. I've had the opportunity of working with very fantastic people in our organization who come with a lot of passion, who are creative, and who have been like creating very well to our company. With this, I would say, like, you know, you can like talk to our partners, are some of our senior people are there, part of this. You can explore the opportunities with us in terms of how you can leverage your interest in terms of being part of the gaming industry. With this, I would say thank you. So we do have internship programs for people. So I would say that the best, in my experience, people who are interested to start their career would be as a QA tester. Where if you know how to play games, you start your career testing games. So you get an opportunity about how does the game work, what are the things which are available over there, what are the skills which are there. From there, then there are other opportunities that a person can explore, like getting into product management, getting into the other areas within the team. And in case, we do have some internship programs where we have been visiting these design schools, and we have provided them opportunities to work with us so that they get an exposure about during their college time, they are able to spend time with us, that they are able to get an understanding about what it is to be part of a real game team or part of working with a team. So this helps them to like really understand all those things. So we do have internship programs and all those things.
Yes.
So I want to ask, what kind of same position are we going to do? Like EA for say someone who has been who has a bachelor's degree in say a sciences field technical or something, and has been pursuing HR on site, has a few small projects that he has uploaded on say Facebook or future, right? So what sort of position can someone like that sing?
First of all, when we are looking at hiring people to start with our entry level positions, educational qualification is not something that we're looking at. We're looking for somebody who is a gamer, who is able to understand the game dynamics. So that is the reason when I said accepting like roles like engineering and all, we definitely look for engineering degree. But when we are looking at the other areas to start with, especially with QA and all, educational degree is not important, but it is more about, does the person know how to play games? And as the person is being part of the organization, he or she would understand what are the skills and competencies which are required to grow in that role. Does that answer your question?
I was actually asking, someone who is already part of the game development industry, say someone who is already maybe into the game side of it and wants to join the EA.
Yeah, sure. You can just look into the positions, open positions that we have listed on our website. And I do have my colleague from talent acquisition team, or you can just speak to me. And maybe, we can just discuss this offline in terms of what are the areas, what has been your previous experience that you're interested in, that we can just like explore. Yeah.
So you just mentioned that it is not necessary for a person to have a degree.
Yeah.
Let's say B.Tech degree. Can you mention the other thing that you look for in the candidate?
Yes.
So can you highlight a few such things, something specific that I can put in points that a person has and that makes him stand out as a game developer or a programmer or a designer?
See, in terms of developer and a programmer, definitely the technical skills are important, like the technical degree is important. But here when I'm talking about it, I'm also talking about the non-technical skills, that is more in terms of competencies and capabilities, where we are talking about person's problem-solving skills, person's collaborative skills, communication skills. Communication skills are very important. I'm not talking about the talking skills, but for example, a person who is a tester and he's supposed to document the bugs or the findings, he or she should be able to write it in such a way, because you're working with teams who are outside India. So you should be able to communicate very well with the teams, where whatever you are entering into the main tools, that it's been communicated very easily. So it's all these skills are very important as you go senior, like the non-technical skills, like problem solving, collaborations, communication skills, emotional intelligence, how are you handling uncertainty, and those kind of skills are also important. Yeah.
Any more questions? No?
Yeah, I think we're good.
Thank you so much.